Okay, I guess the only thing really to do right now is to talk to him.
What's on your mind, Captain?
Dr. McCoy, he's very sick.
Hmm.
You wouldn't happen to be related to Vakata Sheem by any chance?
Well, that's Sheem. He said his name was Shem.
Do you realize that you're working for a madman? When do we eat around here?
I want to know who Vakata Sheem is.
Do you realize you wouldn't happen to be related to Vakata Sheem by any chance?
Yes. He was my father.
How's he doing?
He's dead. He tried to betray the Vardane Starship program to the Federation and was executed 9 years ago.
I'm sorry to hear that. I knew him when I was on Vardane. He was a good man.
Obviously, someone felt differently. Since then, Dr. Bredell took me under his wing. I proved more able as a security officer than as a scientist.
Then you should know that Bredell is insane.
Hmm, could be a good line of dialogue here. A line of questioning, conversation, whatever you want to call it.
Why don't you try coming inside for a moment? Let's see how tough a security officer you are.
Oh my.
And what do you think of your father's death? Then you should know that Bredell is insane.
Hmm, what do you think of your father's death?
And what do you think of your father's death?
I think we're gonna pursue this area here. Actually, can I... I'm locked in now. I want to try some other choices, but...
Why don't you... Then you should know... And what do you think of your father's death? Then you should... Why don't you try coming inside for a moment? Let's see how tough a security officer you are.
I'm choosing this right now. I know it's not going to work, but I want to quit out. I want to ask him when food time is and stuff like that as well.
Starfleet captains aren't stupid. And if you've been on Vardane, you know our physical strength and fighting skill. I don't normally back down from a challenge, but I'm not going to respond like a simpleton.
Alright.
What's on your mind, Captain?
Dr. McCoy, he's very sick. You wouldn't happen to be... Do you realize that you're working for a madman? When do we eat around here?
Not for a while, Captain. You'll be stunned by a direct phaser before the meal. And when you're unconscious, the meal will be brought to you.
You're all hard.
Captain, I don't believe in taking stupid risks. I know Starfleet. I don't intend to underestimate you. What's on your mind, Captain?
Dr. McCoy, he's very sick.
Just trying to get all the dialogue we can out of this guy.
When do we eat around here? Do you realize that you're working for a madman?
I don't have a high opinion of his mental stability, Captain.
We've heard a report that leads me to believe he intends to kill billions of people.
Hmm.
What do you know of his plans? Working for a madman sounds rather dangerous to me.
Yeah, it is at that.
We've heard a report that leads me to believe working for a madman sounds rather dangerous to me.
Let's see this one.
I don't think either one of us has ever been intimidated by danger.
Do you want me to tell you what frightens me? Bredell's plans frighten me. The deaths of 100 billion people, men, women, and children, frightens me.
Hmm.
Don't be absurd. Danger always intimidates. That doesn't mean we avoid it when the cause is just.
True.
You're avoiding the point. Bredell's a maniac. He must be stopped. For the sake of Vardane, as well as the other members of the Federation.
Any more choices?
Do you want me to tell you? You're avoiding the point.
Give me one good reason why I should betray everything I believe in to help you.
We came to Espoir because a starship returned from the future and told us that in 8 days the Federation would be destroyed. We tracked the starship's course to this system. I believe that Bredell is about to do something that will have cataclysmic consequences.
What about the short answer?
I can't reveal my information, but I have strong reason to believe that Bredell is planning something that will destroy many billions of lives. Help us, please. We came to Espoir because a star... I can't reveal my information.
Captain, if you can't trust me with your information, then I'm not going to betray my friends and my duty. I'll keep my ears open, but as far as I'm concerned, this conversation is at an end.
Hmm. Now that other option might work, but I kind of like the line of talking about his father, so I'm going to go back to that.
You get no response.
Or not, because I get no response at this point.
You get no response.
I didn't know that would happen.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
This section of the wall could use a doctor. Maybe Spock should take a crack at this.
I really don't want to go have to go through that battle all over again. I had no idea that would happen, guys, so I'm just gonna try to use Spock on this.
Interesting, Captain. I believe that this is a weakness in the superstructure of this station. It is possible that we may be able to use this weakness to escape.
Oh, no, you don't.
Nice. Well, we didn't deal with him. Instead, we knocked him out.
An unconscious Manao Shen. You notice something in his pocket.
You notice something in his pocket.
I would advise against reviving him, Captain.
I think I see some sort of computer card in his pocket, Mr. Spock.
Yes. I guess that Mr. Spock will get this. Computer card.
He is unconscious, Captain. There is an object in his pocket. It would appear to be some sort of computer card.
Spock's deaf. Maybe we use the get command then. There we go.
I have found no weapons, but there is a pass card.
Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so now we've got a little bag. Here's our inventory. We have so many things. Just can't believe it.
A computerized pass card.
Okay. We can't analyze it because it doesn't have an analyzer. Normally he'd have his tricorder, science, I guess, tricorder, and we'd have his medical tricorder and his bag of goodies, which is a medical kit, and a few other things that I can't remember right now. So let's leave. Can we leave? Yes. Look at everything.
This seems pointless. A pass card reader. This device opens the lockers when the appropriate pass card is inserted.
Oh, so these are lockers. I really didn't know what these were.
This turns off the force field control on the cell.
Let's turn that back on so he can't get out. Nice.
This is the station's brig.
Hmm.
Dr. McCoy looks at the cell in disgust. Mr. Spock considers a logical solution to their problem.
Why ever would he do that?
James Kirk is relieved not to be in the cell, but realizes the odds are very much against him.
So now we can look at him. It didn't work before. What else is here?
The door to the turbo lift.
Turbo lift.
A pass card reader.
Pass card
this
reader.
Device opens the lockers when the appropriate pass card is inserted.
How about this?
A communication panel.
Hmm.
This turns off the force field control on the cell. This turns off the force field control on the cell.
Same, okay.
The floor.
The floor!
This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
And the floor wasn't pointless?
Got nothing to say.
Hmm.
Jim, stop at a place where I can write my last will and testament.
Heaven forbid, Bones.
Oh, prophetic words. How sad.
The layout of this base is interesting, Captain. Its modular design makes it easier for a small security detachment to guard.
The Vardane values secrecy even more than security.
Hmm. Is this anything? A symbol?
The floor.
Yeah, it's a floor. Okay. So these open the lockers?
A pass card reader. This device opens the lockers when the appropriate...
Okay, I can use the other mouse button to cut it off. Got it. Let's use our card here. First, almost walk into the force field, then go over there. Nice. Stuff. I like stuff.
A locker. It is unlocked. This is where communicators are being kept.
Maybe we should call it an unlocker.
A locker. It is unlocked. This is where your tricorders and med kit are being kept.
Right, the communicator's the other thing.
A locker. It is unlocked. This is where your phasers are being kept.
Phasers, nice, okay. Get all.
Q Communicators taken. Tricorders and medkit taken.
Phasers taken.
Phasers taken.
Now we have all our stuff, just like we normally would. Can we look at these things?
Standard Starfleet phaser. Set for stun. Standard Starfleet phaser. Set for kill.
Kill? Oh, wait a second.
Standard Starfleet science tricorder. Standard Starfleet medical tricorder. Full of all known Federation lifeform data.
That should be a lot of data.
Communicators taken. Standard Starfleet medical kit. More than just band-aids in this little black box.
I would hope so. Let's try to hail the Enterprise.
Kirk to Enterprise. Kirk to Enterprise.
Transmission detected in prison sector. Security forces converge on prison sector.
We're being jammed. We have to disable the station's communication system if we want to contact the Enterprise.
That and aren't people coming? If so, I might have to start this one over. Let's analyze stuff.
The floor is made from solid uranium steel alloy. Its structural integrity appears to have been weakened by a time-space phenomenon. But this section of floor is still strong.
Really? Is there another section that isn't strong?
The floor is made from solid uranium. Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. The floor is made from solid uranium.
All right.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
What about this force field?
Nothing unusual about that object.
The door?
Nothing unusual about that object. Nothing unusual about that object.
All right, all right. Well, no one's coming yet.
The floor isn't alive, Jim.
Could you imagine if it was?
Vulcan male in excellent physical condition.
And yourself?
Middle-aged male human in average physical condition.
Well, at least he's honest.
Young male human in good physical condition.
Kirk never struck me as being really that young, but I guess he was.
Nothing on this tricorder, Captain.
All right. I don't know about this door. Can we go this way? Nope. Can we go through the door? Will it just open? Yes, it will. Ooh, we can go around the station. Oh, yellow alert we got. Okay. So this is a vacuum then. Life support is in these green areas. Under construction. I guess it'll be here. And here. Is that docking bay 2? Riddell's quarters, crew quarters, transporter, computer room, central control, security room, executive quarters, and special projects. Where's the brig? I guess security room? Detention. Oh, we must be here in detention. Right. Well, before I go anywhere new, I'd like to save the game. Which is done this way. Gotta remind myself.
Save new game.
Okay. Cause you know, wherever we go is gonna randomly we could be captured and killed or whatever. So, what if we go here? We can't go there. We've got docking bay 1.
Surrender or die.
Surrender. Or we'll phaser the airlock and we'll all go flying out together.
Nice.
Can I have 5 minutes to think about it?
You and your 5 minutes, Kirk.
We surrender. Surrender. Or we'll we surrender. Can I have 5 minutes to think about it?
No.
Spock, fire. Okay, we surrender. Spock, fire.
What's going on here? Is this how millions of people die? Oh, yeah, I would say billions then. So that's how it happened. Huh.
Enterprise, this is Captain Luke Rayner of the USS Alexander. We have returned from the future.
Alright.
My God.
Let me reload my save. Thank you. Now that's pretty neat, the way it showed us that. Okay, let's not go to the docking bay. This one's under construction, though. Can't go there. What if we go to the computer room?
There they are! Get them! Fire!
Phaser's on stun.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
I hate when they do that.
Oh, he's still okay. He was stunned.
The stunned guard lies prone on the floor.
They're probably going to get up eventually.
The stunned guard lies prone on the floor. Kirk wishes that these people would stop shooting at him.
No kidding.
McCoy has decided this is not a spot that he'll visit on his next vacation.
Bedell's ship? I would hope not.
Spock appears to be in deep thought. The floor is marked with a tricolor grid.
Oh yeah, and I noticed they correspond to these colors.
This door is labeled computers.
Computers.
This door is labeled transporter room.
Okay.
This door is labeled security.
Cool.
This door is labeled central control. The wall looks very solid.
Huh.
The wall looks very solid.
What's this?
This seems pointless.
I'm just looking at it.
Here we are, in the heart of Bredell's mad sanctum. I wish I could be more confident.
Jim, why does everyone not like me? Why does everyone keep shooting at me?
I don't know, but I guess it's your cheerful nature and your stoic silence.
Yeah, where's our red shirt this time?
Captain, I would place a high priority on finding a way to win over the security team.
The Vardane think they supersede mankind.
Mr. Shem indicated that the Vardane had little love for Bedell, Captain. I suspect their loyalty is less than absolute.
Might have something there.
Well, Spock, what do you suggest?
We should attempt to gather evidence that Dr. Bedell is planning to commit genocide. Others may help us if they are confronted with the scope of Bredell's misdeeds. We must find out what Bredell's plan is. If we could find the central computer records, we may be able to tap into them and learn his exact plan. We need to shut down the tractor beam that is currently holding the Enterprise. Until the ship is freed, our options are limited. We should not forget that we need to be able to communicate freely with the ship. It will be necessary for us to neutralize any source of interference. Our chief priority is to find the reason for the Holocaust that was reported by the Alexander and stop it from occurring.
Very good. I'm going to resave.
Replace previous.
Now, what's this again?
This door is labeled security.
Really, what I want to do right now is explore. Can we just go through these doors at will?
The door is locked, Jim.
Are any of them open? This one is.
Jim, what's that smell?
Wanaka gas. A knockout gas with an extremely long effect.
We have mere seconds to neutralize it or get out of here.
Huh.
Transporter controls. Dr. McCoy. For a doctor, he has very little patience.
Haha, got it.
Jim Kirk. He hasn't seen the trap that human ingenuity can't overcome.
Yeah, we don't really have much time. Okay, maybe not go in there. What are these other ones?
This door is labeled computers.
Hmm. That would be our obvious next step.
This door is labeled central control.
Yeah, let's go to computers if it's open. Greetings!
You're too late. I've set the computer on a continuous auto-diagnostic. You'll never be able to get it online.
I don't believe in the word never.
Damn you, sir!
A three-dimensional chess set.
Oh, he's attacking us as well. And again, he's attacking Bones first. Poor Bones. Holy crap, man.
Dr. Leonard McCoy doesn't like working with machines, but doesn't like primitive medicine either.
Hmm.
A rather unconscious computer technician. James Kirk never seems at ease in a room full of computers.
Oh, that's even worse than the damn transporter.
Kirk doesn't like computers. Well, he's surrounded by them. This is the future.
Mr. Spock seems perfectly at home in a room full of computers.
Most logical, indeed.
A three-dimensional chess set.
Right, so that's a chess set.
A chair.
That's a chair.
The central processor of the main computer.
CPU.
The central processor of the main...
Still part of the CPU. I see the chess set. What is this going on here?
The laser beam flits around the board, leaving three-dimensional images behind in its wake.
If you have to play 3D chess to get in this computer, yeah, it's going to take forever.
The memory unit of the station's main computer.
Hmm.
A micro hollow beam projector, usable to create light images on the chess game.
On button?
A three-dimensional chess set. This seems pointless.
Huh.
The floor. The circuit diagrams are clearly a decoration.
Okay, doke, what's this?
A display monitor.
Mm-hmm.
Computers, I better start thinking of something illogical to say.
Huh. How so?
Well, Spock, do you feel at home here?
My home is Vulcan, Doctor. Its physical appearance is quite dissimilar to this place.
There are machines here, Spock. Computers. This is where you belong, isn't it?
My place, Doctor, is as science officer aboard the USS Enterprise.
Spock, if you left the Enterprise, I'm sure you could find a job substituting for one of these mechanical marvels.
Actually, Doctor, the computing capacity of one of these machines is substantially faster than the processing power of the Vulcan brain.
So you admit that you are inferior?
In speed and memory, affirmative. Other areas exist, Doctor, where even you are superior to this machine.
That's the nicest thing you've ever said to me, Spock.
Oh my, how these two go on, huh?
These are various advanced designs, Captain. They appear to work on a modified Daystrom Duotronic system, version 9.0, with some enhancements I do not recognize.
Mm-hmm. Let's analyze stuff. How's our patient doing?
Middle-aged human male, currently unconscious.
Hmm.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
It's 3D chess.
Fullingtech 2000 3D image projector. The majority of the system must be stored on an upper deck. This system is quite bulky, like most 3D projection units. The tricorder can tap into the core memory, provided that we can end the diagnostic cycle.
How do we end the cycle? By playing chess with it?
Captain, the main computers are behind the chess set. I will attempt to access them.
Okay.
We will need to end the diagnostic cycle, Captain. It is currently playing chess against itself.
Aha. Uh-huh. Can you do that?
We will need to end the diagnostic cycle, Captain. I do not see the logic in that action.
Play chess with it?
Captain, the computer is locked into an infinite loop. It will continue playing the game until it defeats itself. I can interrupt the moves and input my own.
Try a rook to queen's level 3. That will threaten its bishop.
I have no idea about this stuff, guys. I mean, technically I do know how to play chess, but that would be... I'm not even sure if you could consider me a beginner.
Try knight to king level 1. That will shore up our defenses. Try queen to queen's level 2. Let's sacrifice our queen to take that knight. Try rook to queen's level 3. That will threaten its bishop.
Choosing randomly?
An excellent move.
Now let's push a pawn on king's level. That will force it into a more stable position. Now move your other rook to support it on queen's level. We should be able to threaten the queen or the bishop.
Well, that one sounds good so far.
Let's try something a little dangerous. Rook to king's level 2.
So all we have to remember are the choices. First one is 1, and now we'll go...
Now move your other rook to support it on queen's level.
2.
It seemed to be expecting something else, Captain. Its queen is vulnerable.
Let's not be too hasty. Advancing the bishop to support the rook will give us a solid advantage on the board. Let's confuse it with a sacrifice. It might be interesting to trade queens. Let's take the queen and see if it resigns. Let's confuse it with a sacrifice.
Yes.
It has made the trade. Both of our offenses have been substantially weakened.
Let's prevent it from using his bishop to save his rook. Bishop to king's level 2. Now let's trade rooks. Now is the time to sacrifice our rook. Rook to queen's level 3.
I'm not even paying attention when I'm choosing. I really should be. What do we do? 1, 2, 2? I don't even know. I know the first one is 1. ? I'm gonna choose 3 right now.
It has mated you, Captain.
Boo hiss!
It has also completed the diagnostic cycle.
Way to go, Jim!
Excellent, Spock. Can you access the computer?
The main memory unit will not accept my attempts to access. I will need to find a more friendly interface with enough memory to hold the information.
Could you use your tricorder interface? You've done that before. Well, we've done that before.
Captain, I am connecting the science tricorder to the central computer.
Good.
We can use it to tap into the computer now that the diagnostic cycle is finished. We might use Dr. McCoy's tricorder as well.
Yes, I was thinking that might help. We did a similar thing in, really, the last episode. Right before we fought the Enterprise 2 and, Bradell. The USS Republic's computer had been badly damaged. And we had to use both our tricorders to help the damaged computer on board the Republic do its duty and get one system functioning at a time.
Captain, I am connecting the medical tricorder to the central computer.
I'm really liking this episode. This is pretty much, so far I'd say, pretty much on a par with that last episode of our 25th anniversary, which was my favorite episode. It was a hoot and a holler. How are we doing here?
The central processor of the main computer.
Okay, we're looking at things that look the same.
Success, Captain. I have access to Burdell's Project Big Bang files, and to the access code for his personal quarters.
Oh, good. Anything new to say?
These are various advanced designs, Captain.
Okay, I'm guessing we're done here.
Save new game.
Let's save a new game just in case we're being tricked into a false sense of security here. Well, we stunned those guys and they're gone. Central core is here.
Phasers on stun.
Uh-oh.